When a patient presents with chest pain in the emergency department, the first investigation they do is an ECG. And the physician looks for changes in the ST segment to diagnose or to rule out an acute coronary syndrome, which is called as ACS. In case of an ACS, the ST segment could either be elevated or it could be depressed. A patient with chest pain and ST segment elevation, the most likely diagnosis is a myocardial infarction, and the person is said to have a ST segment elevated myocardial infarction, and the most appropriate treatment would be a primary percutaneous coronary intervention as early as possible. But if a person with chest pain has ST segment depression, then the physician thinks of ischemia rather than infarction. And this is due to decreased blood supply and it is causing an unstable angina. The patient is then labeled as NSTE acute coronary syndrome, that is non-ST segment elevation acute coronary syndrome. This is most likely due to a subendocardial ischemia, which happens due to a decreased blood supply rather than a complete loss of blood supply. Though this statement is true that when there is ST segment elevation, possibly, most probably it is AMI, and when there is an ST segment depression, it's most probably due to an ischemia. But the converse is not true. That is, the infarction does not always cause an ST segment, and ischemia does not always cause an ST depression. So there's a misunderstanding with beginners that they always think that ischemia means it would cause a depression, whereas there is an infarction, it would cause an elevation always. No, that's not the case. In this video, we are going to discuss this. It is what is the electrophysiological basis of an ST segment elevation and a ST segment depression. Let's start with a normal ST segment. Normal ST segment is isoelectric, which means the entire myocardium is electrically in a same state. Like this is an isoelectric line. It happens at the PR interval, ST segment and TP segment. So these are the regions where the segment is supposed to be isoelectric. The isoelectric segment happens when the heart is either completely in a resting membrane potential, like in a phase 4 of an ventricular action potential, or in a phase 2 where the membrane is completely depolarized, the entire ventricle myocardium is completely depolarized. This phase 4 of ventricular action potential corresponds to the ST segment. So that is the responsible for this isoelectric region. So when there is all the cells are electrically same, there is no potential difference across the myocardium. Whereas if the cell is partially depolarized and partially in the resting membrane state, there is a electrical current which passes between these group of cells to the other group of cells, normal cells, which will cause a potential. And this all the sum of all the currents will be having a net vector in a particular direction, and that will be the vector for the particular wave. Here, this is phase 0, 1 and 0. This is a QRS complex due to ventricular repolarization. When the ventricle is completely depolarized, then that's the point is called as the J point, which is the beginning of completely depolarized state, and it ends with the beginning of the T wave. So this interval is called as a ST segment, and this is an isoelectric period. And once the repolarization begins, the T wave is produced and the isoelectric period is lost. Again, the phase 4 of the action potential now is going to loss from the end of the T wave to the beginning of the QRS complex. This is an isoelectric period for the ventricle, though there is a wave in between, which is a P wave, which is an atrial event. Now let's see what happens to a ventricular myocyte and the ST segment when there is an ischemia. Ischemia refers to a decreased blood supply, or in other words, decreased supply demand ratio, and this causes a decrease in local availability of ATP, decrease in oxygen, and it causes an increase in potassium levels in the local region, and also it causes acidosis. a local acidosis. So these changes, the local hyperkalemia and acidosis, they are going to change the properties of the ion channels involved in action potential generation. So they are going to change that and action potential morphology, which initially causes a change in the T wave morphology, which is the first change which happens in the ECG in a myocardial ischemia. As the ischemia progresses, the membrane potential becomes lesser and lesser negative. From minus 90 of resting membrane potential, it gradually becomes less and less negative, and the membrane potential is now, the resting membrane potential is now said to be in a depolarized state. As the membrane depolarize further, the sodium channels undergo inactivation. If the sodium channels are inactivated, there is no action potential and there is no contraction also. These two changes are going to produce the changes in the ST segment, which we are going to study later. If the ischemia continues and if it is severe, the cells are undergo cell necrosis. The membrane is going to rupture, the contents are going to come out. This can be detected in the serum as increase in cardiac biomarkers, which is a sure sign of myocardial cell injury. But before this happens, there is a electrically inactive state. The cell goes into a completely electrically inactive. It becomes an electrical insulator, though this is a reversible state. In a ECG, this represents as a Q wave. All these conditions, electrically inactive state, cell death and a scar tissue, they are all electrically insulator, electrical insulator region. Whenever this happens, there is a Q wave which appears in the ECG, which indicates a presence of necrosis. So this, though this is a electrocardiac marker, the actual marker for cell death would be a cardiac biomarker elevation in the serum. Now let's see what happens to the ST segment. So to understand that, what happens when the myocardium is going to get injured, that's what we are going to see. So we have to understand the concept called as injury current to understand ST segment changes during an ischemia. So these gray cells represents a normal myocardium. Now all the cells are in a resting membrane potential, that is inside negative and outside positive, minus 90 millivolt. Since this is electrically homogeneous, there is not going to be any current flowing between the cells. But if a cell or a group of cell is injured, something like this, now even at phase 4, at resting membrane potential, all the cells are in resting membrane potential, this cell is depolarized. There is a potential difference between these cells and the other cells. So this is going to create a current flow from negative to positive. Like you can remember, like flow of electrons from negative to positive, this is going to create a current flow. This causes a net current flow in a particular vector. Let's draw in this particular direction. So this is the net vector flowing in this particular injury, even in phase 4. So this current, if it is recorded in an electrode, for example, if it is recorded in a lead 3 has a positive electrode here and a negative electrode over here. So positive electrode in the foot and in the negative electrode in the left arm. In this condition, the injury current is flowing with the same direction as the lead 3. So it is going to record a positive wave. Whereas if we record the same injury current from AVL, where the positive electrode is in the left arm and the negative electrode is in the center of the heart, this is, the vector is going in the opposite direction from the positive. So this is going to develop a negative wave if we record the same event from an AVL. So though the injury current is the same, it vector depends upon, the direction depends upon from which lead we are recording it. So let's move on to apply this to the ST segment and see what happens. This is a normal myocardium, and these are two types of ischemia. One is a subendocardial ischemia in the left ventricle lateral wall, and this is the lateral wall of the left ventricle, and it's a transmural ischemia, which is a complete ischemia. So since the electrical homogeneity is preserved in a normal cell, the ST segment is in a isoelectric line. In a subendocardial ischemia, there is going to be a cell which have a different polarity than the normal cells, because this is the ischemic cells which are depolarized. So there is going to be a current flowing from these cells to the other region, and a net electrical vector of all this current can be drawn like this towards the epicardium, from endocardium towards the epicardium. So the subendocardial ischemia with a vector like this can be recorded from a lead one, which is also called as a lateral lead. It will be recording a positive deflection because it is going towards the positive electrode. In case of transmural ischemia, again there is going to be a lot of current flowing from the damage to the tissue, normal tissue. The net vector, electrical vector, is going to be in a direction somewhat like this. And since this vector is away from the positive of this recording electrode, lead one, this is going to produce a negative deflection. So you can see here, both are ischemia happening in a similar region, but they are producing a different response in the leads. They are producing a different injury current, deflection, positive and negative. This is mainly because the vector is different. One is a subendocardium only, and the other is a transmural. Though both are ischemia, they are producing a different change. So the subendocardial ischemia, there is going to be a ST depression, and the transmural ischemia, there is going to be ST elevation. So now you may wonder, this injury current is positive, but the ST segment is getting depressed over here. The injury current is negative, the ST segment is getting elevated over here. This is because the injury current is acting on the other stages, other phases of ECG, and not during the ST segment. So we are going to see this particular concept in detail. That is why the injury current, though it is positive, the ST segment is getting depressed, going it in other direction. So this is subendocardial ischemia, and is a different phases of action potential. Phase 4 is the resting membrane potential, but there is a group of cells which are already depolarized, but they are permanently depolarized. They are not going to generate any action potential, and the neck vector is going to be somewhat like this, from the subendocardium towards the epicardium. And if we record this thing from a lead one, this is going to produce a positive deflection. And when we gradually progress to phase 2, this normal cell also depolarized and the ischemic cell also depolarized. Now the injury current is going to be zero, or it could be minimal. So what this would cause is that whenever in the phase 4, that is from a TP segment till the beginning of the QRS complex, from here and this regions, there is going to be a positive augmentation to the entire ECG. Okay, so this is considered as normal, and the rest of the ECG is positively getting augmented. And this injury current is zero, so the ST segment does not receive any augmentation, so the ST segment appears depressed. Though this ST segment appears depressed, actually, strictly speaking, this is the isoelectric line, and the rest of the ECG is getting increased because of injury current. That's a real understanding of this thing. And the similar thing happens in a transmural ischemia. This is a transmural ischemia, that net vector is going to be in this direction, and this causes a negative wave during the phase 4 and the other phases. And in phase 2, there is not going to be any injury current. So this will cause the phase 4, which is most of the ECG, which is going to be depressed because of this negative wave. But the ST segment does not receive much of the injury current component, so it appears slightly elevated. So actually, this is supposed to be the normal level, and the rest of the ECG is supposed to be depressed. But when we conventionally use this ECG machines, they take this as isoelectric baseline, and it appears, the ST segment appears elevated. So this is because of the injury current, which is absent in the ST segment during transmural ischemia. So in summary, a subendocardial ischemia or in fact will cause an ST segment depression, and a transmural ischemia or in fact will cause an ST segment elevation. So it does not matter whether it is a ischemia or in fact, it mainly determined by the vector, which is again determined by the whether it is sub location, subendocardium or transmural, that will determine whether it's a ST segment depression or a ST segment elevation. But in clinical protocols, what is most common is used. So a patient with the elevation, it is most commonly due to infarction. So when there is a ST segment elevation, then it is most commonly an infarction. So when a person present with the elevation, we think of myocardial infarction. But when there is chest pain and ST segment depression, the most common thing is ischemia 90% of the time, and infarct is rare. So we think of a subendocardial ischemia. So though we correlate elevation with infarction and depression with ischemia, actually they are not directly originating like that in the electrophysiological studies. I hope you understand. Thank you.